Almost everyone's doing laundry wrong, and here's the wild proof. 100 million loads get washed every single day, half of fabric conditioner, but less than 5% use vinegar. And that's insane, because vinegar might actually be the smartest cleaning chemical in your house. So why does it matter? Because what most people think is making their laundry softer is actually wrecking it. Fabric conditioner is basically just oil and synthetic perfume that clings to your clothes and gums up your washing machine. Vinegar, on the other hand, is the total opposite. It cleans up after the cleaning, but only if you know how and when to use it. Stick around, because we're going deep today. The real science behind your wash cycle, what detergents, enzymes, bleaches and boosters are actually doing, how pH affects your fabrics, and where vinegar fits in this chemical experiment that runs every time you hit start on your washing machine. Think of detergent as a toolbox. Surfactants are the crowbars that lift grease and oil off fibres. Builders adjust the water so the cleaning crew can work properly. Some detergents, biologicals, add enzymes, tiny workers that attack protein, starch and fat. They're like little plungers pulling out stains at the microscopic level. Non-bio formulations avoid enzymes and often rely on oxygen bleaches. Common examples are sodium percarbonate or perborate, which release hydrogen peroxide when dissolved. This peroxide then attacks organic soils like tea, coffee, wine, sweat, and other foodstuffs. Laundry boosters are the power-ups people add for heavy or white loads. They usually contain alkaline builders like washing soda or sodium carbonate, a peroxide source, and sometimes activators or extra enzyme packs. Boosters crank alkalinity and peroxide availability, sometimes pushing effective pH up to about 11.5. Which is a huge difference. The difference between pH 9, 10 and 11 isn't a factor of 1, 2, 3, it's a factor of 10 for each step, so pH 11 is about 10,000 times stronger than pH 8. Alkalinity helps the whole system. It improves surfactant action, that's soap to you and I, and assists bleach activation, but it's a double-edged sword. High alkalinity and repeated bleaching slowly chew away at your fabrics. Cotton swells, weakens and eventually frays. That's why your bedsheets tear and your jeans eventually give away at the knees. Protein fibres like wool and silk are sensitive to high pH and to proteases, that's the enzyme that breaks down protein, so wool and silk detergents avoid enzymes and strong bleaches. Synthetic fibres don't swell the same way, but they're hydrophobic, which means they repel water. But these fibres can retain detergent films along with body odours. So yes, alkaline chemistry cleans brilliantly, but it also sets the stage for a rinse phase acid, like vinegar, to neutralise residues, close fibres back down, and remove mineral deposits, which is exactly why vinegar's role in the rinse matters. Think of it like a party. Detergent cleans up the mess, but leaves beer cans, sticky floors and crumbs everywhere. Vinegar, on the other hand, is the one who comes in at the end, wipes it all down, and actually makes the place livable again. Let's break down exactly how it works. So here are its 5 best tricks in the rinse cycle. The first thing it does is strip away that leftover alkaline film, the detergent residue that irritates skin and eczema. Clothes come out genuinely clean, not coated. And it doesn't stop there. Remember how alkaline water made cotton swell up like bloated pasta? Vinegar flips that. It pulls fibres back into shape, cotton feels smoother, wool scales lie flat, and the fibres of your clothes are softer. Vinegar also tackles odour head on. Where fabric softener just sprays perfume over the crown seam, vinegar actually breaks apart the compounds that trap sweat and stink in gym gear and towels. What's left isn't fake fragrance, it's real freshness. Vinegar fights hard water. Calcium and magnesium salts make towels feel like cardboard and clog your washing machine. Vinegar actually dissolves them, and suddenly your scratchy towels become soft again. For me, the biggest benefit is that fabric conditioner adds oil and perfume to hide problems. Vinegar does the exact opposite. It subtracts, stripping away residue, minerals and funk. This leaves you with softer towels, fresher t-shirts, happier skin and more money in your pocket because the vinegar costs buttons. That's the genius of the pH scale and acid-base chemistry. Less crap, better wash. Now, how do we use this wonder liquid? Only ever in the rinse cycle, never in the main wash, because vinegar neutralises the detergent, peroxide and enzymes, making them absolutely useless. You don't need much, about a quarter cup, 60 mils or so, for routine washes, half a cup, 120 mils, for heavy towels. Use it weekly for towels and sheets, every couple of weeks for gym gear, and only occasionally for everyday clothes if they feel stiff. Wool and silk, not really necessary if you're using a specialist detergent, but if you do, stick to a small dose. This is part of my home chemistry series where I apparently spend my free time talking to detergent. If that sounds like your kind of madness, you'll love my deep dive on pH. It's basically cleaning therapy with nice graphics. So go watch that next. And if you enjoy this kind of chaos disguised as education, hit subscribe. I'm aiming for 100,000 subscribers because apparently that's what validates a grown man talking about vinegar online.